my creatives and welcome to another video. So today I'm here to share something very, very exciting with you. But first of all, I'm going to tell you what I'm doing right now. So first of all, I'm cutting this strip of craft cardstock at 5 inches. And now I'm cutting them at 3 inches wide. And now I will score them at 1 inch, 2 inch and 1.5 inch because I remembered something else. So 3 pieces of 3 by 5 inches, then score them at 1 inch, 1.5 inch and 2 inches, and then you are going to create some type of accordion fold thingy. So as you can see me doing here, that you have this V shape, because that will be the base of this flipbook that I am creating today. And I'm using the Craft Consortium paper pad because I am doing a swap with Marley Design, or a collaboration with Marley Design. And we decided on creating a botanical flipbook for each other. So if you don't know Marley Design, she is a wonderful crafter and a wonderful lovely lady, and she contacted me on Instagram to do a swap together, because she has set some goals for herself to reach out to people and do creative things together. And of course I said yes, because I absolutely loved it that she set that as a goal, and I wanted to help her with that. So we decided to do this collaboration together. So here you see my process video of what I created for Marlies, or Marley Design. And on her channel, you will see what she created for me. As recording this voiceover, I haven't seen what she recorded for she made for me. So I'm very, very excited about that. All of her information is linked down below in the description box. So you can check out her YouTube channel and her Instagram. So now I'm going to tell you what I'm doing. So I created my pages for my flipbook, which are 5 by 6 inches. And now I am adhering them to the base of my flipbook. So I'm going to adhere them to the outer flaps and make sure that you don't put your paper over the scoring line, because that will be your hinge for this flipbook. It's very exciting because it is something I never did before, how I am assembling this one. That's also why this video is quite a bit longer, because I did something I never did before. It was very exciting, and I absolutely love the end result, and I'm very happy with what I made for Marlies. So here I'm just assembling my pages. So I used some Craft Consortium papers and some Atlas paper. These are in the back of the Atlas. And now I'm going to create my flipbook. I let everything dry, and now I'm going to stack them together. So as you can see, I am refolding, and these little V shapes, you remember them, that we made them, those will be part of the binding. So this is a no-sew binding, but I'm going to use my crocodile and some eyelets for this. And that is actually the first time that I used that tool for this purpose. So I did make some errors, which I will show you. First of all, I'm going to try to line everything up together. So I just stack the papers, and then I will find the center point of this. Here's my crocodile. I'm very, very excited to use it for this. And I'm going to pick out 3 eyelets for this. So I'm using some brownish type because I'm going for a vintage botanical style. And I'm going to, as you see here, create my binding. So I found the middle part, which is of course 2.5 inch, because this flipbook is 5 inches on top, and I made sure to put 1/2 inch on the top and the bottom to have enough space for my hole, so it wouldn't get away or off of my flipbook. So now I'm going to find the center point. I was a bit perfectionist, I have to say, with this, which is not necessary because the eyelets are pretty big. So if it moves a little bit up or down, you don't really see it. But now I'm going to create my holes with my crocodile, which was very easy to do. And I made sure that I tried to hit the center point. So now I'm going to add my crocodile, and I used my crocodile upside down for the first one. So I was wondering, why doesn't this work? I see everybody do this so easily, and then I figured it out that I had to turn it around. And then it was the most easy thing I ever did. So this is a beautiful, perfect no-sew binding with some eyelets, and I absolutely love the look of it, and I'm very, very happy with this style of flipbook. So I created one where there are 6 pages. And but you can do 4 pages if you want. And now I'm just cutting off some of the excess paper because it's not never perfect. And I was in doubt if I wanted to cut off the bottom, but I thought it would mess up too much with the flipbook and probably couldn't tell when I added all my stuff in there. So let's move on to the front cover of this flipbook. And I am going to use a doily, and I'm going to use several botanical themed things that I have in my stash. So most of these things I bought from AliExpress or are gifted from me or are from the Your Creative Studio box. So that is what I'm going to use today. And now I'm going to assemble my front cover. So I found this beautiful washi sticker with this beautiful red color. And I'm going to adhere everything to my flipbook. So if you have any questions about how I made this flipbook, just leave them down below in the comment section. I will gladly help you with answering them or help you with assembling them. That is no problem at all. You can always ask me anything about the snail mail that I make or any other creative things. No worries about that. I'll gladly answer your questions. So here I'm going to assemble my collage. And if you wonder what I used, everything is linked down below or listed down below in the description box. And if I can find it online, it is linked. Just remember that some of them are affiliate links. So I had to get a bit of a feel for this flipbook. I made this flipbook over several days because I also never make flipbooks this big. That's also why this video is quite long. It has 6 pages, which makes 12 pages, I believe, to decorate. So it was quite a bit of a challenge to make a flipbook that big. But I wanted to do something special for Marlies, as she asked me this and she got out of her comfort zone. So I wanted to give her something special. So I found this little sticker and I'm going to adhere that. And I also add a vintage label that I will find later on or that you already saw me using to add to my collage. As most of you know, I love the Tim Holtz phrase sticker, so of course they had to go on this little flipbook, or not little flipbook, but I thought they were the perfect addition, especially because I like the typewriter font. And now I'm going into a Journal Studio sticker book and I'm going to spell out Hi Marlies, which is her name. As you know, I love to add people's names. And here I am with my newest obsession. I saw Heba from my little journal with washi dots and I was like, I need those in my life. So thank you, Heba, for enabling me. Hashtag Heba make me do it. So I bought a bunch of washi dots on AliExpress and I absolutely love them. As if you are a regular watcher of mine, you know that I run out of gems to add to my projects, and I thought washi dots were a perfect addition. Also because they create no bulk and they are very light, so they are perfect for mail making. So now on this second page, I'm going to create a belly band with one of the scraps that I had left over from the papers that I used inside. And I picked this Flow Book for Paper Lovers paper as my writing paper because, well, it fit the theme beautifully. So I used that as my writing paper. I wasn't happy with the space there was still left for the paper to move in, so I added an extra little piece of tape to prevent it from moving too much. And now I'm creating a collage on the belly band with some goodies from the Your Creative Studio subscription box, and some of that vellum paper I also got from AliExpress. So I like to use vellum with some glue stick because you will not see the adhesive through it, and you can stick it down properly. Beware that the fluid of the glue will make it a bit wrinkly, but it's not, you know, not really bad. It just wrinkles a little bit up, you know, when you add fluids to paper. So I also used one of these stickers that were also a part of Your Creative Studio box. And here I go again with the washi dots. I absolutely, absolutely love them. So I think these are a new favorite in my stash. I bought several colors, of course, because I can never buy one thing to write out. I need all the colors. But I'm very, very happy that I did. And here I'm also going to add some more of the Your Creative Studio stickers. So I really had to get into the feel for this flipbook. I struggled a little bit to get the feels. You know, some projects just come together so easily, and some projects you have a bit of trouble to, you know, get the vibe. So for me, that was this. It's also because I was very, very busy. I wasn't feeling that great. So I, that's also why I decided to do this over several days. And it's also pretty much a big flip book. So it was nice to do it over several days and get a fresh eye every time I started again. So now I'm going to use this sticker book, the Journal Studio sticker book, to add README to the paper. And I'm moving on to the next page. So these papers are also from AliExpress, and I use this beautiful piece as one of the visual points, because I wanted to, you know, alternate between a decorative page and a page with goodies. And because this paper is so thin, I used a glue stick. I really fell in love with glue sticks in my personal journal, which I haven't journaled in for a little while, so I probably should. So I really enjoy using glue sticks for collages or thin papers, and that's what I used here. This is also one of the new washies I bought. I love grid washies or basic washies. So I'm creating a washi collage with this beautiful brown grid, and I'm taking this green grid and tear it to create, to, you know, add more to the collage. And then I'm going to try to figure out what I want to do. So you will see me flipping through this flipbook quite a bit in the video, simply because I was searching for the feeling that I wanted to add. And I also, you probably don't believe it, but I cut out a lot of this video of me umming and ahhing, because I was very, very indecisive. Because I, you know, sometimes you put the pressure on yourself. I wanted to create her something really special, and then sometimes you just put too much pressure on yourself, and that happened to me with this flipbook. But still, I hope that you enjoyed this video and that you like what I made and get some inspiration from it. So I added another quote: sometimes you have to take a chance, and I thought it was perfect for what she did as a New Year's resolution. And she took a chance with me, asking me if I wanted to do this swap with her, and I absolutely loved it. So I was wondering what I wanted to do with the front cover, because I absolutely love the paper. I think it's one of my favorite papers, and I didn't want to cover up too much. So I am using my newest favorite technique, and that is using transparencies on top of each other, because you can still see what is going underneath the collage, but you get this really, really cool texture. I also crumpled it up to create a little bit more texture, and I'm using a glue stick to glue it down so you don't see the glue through the papers, because they are transparent. If you use tape, you would see your tape through it, and that is not something that I want, because then I have to cover up that part. So here again, I am in doubt on what to do, but I will finally figure it out. I even come back later to certain pages to add a bit more, because I was getting the vibe of the page a little bit more. And the funny thing is, when you look back at yourself, especially when you are a content creator, I edit my videos, of course, I see things and I was like, that was perfect. Why didn't I stick with that? So if you ever feel like, wow, why can't I just do it or be as good as the content creators or anything like that, just remember that we are also just people. And we also have the same things. So I don't know. I was just very indecisive with this part. So that beautiful vellum piece also came from the Your Creative Studio kit. And now I'm going again with the washi dots, I believe. Oh no, I'm going to add a butterfly, of course. I know it's a botanical flipbook, but I had to add butterflies. You know, it's me. I have to add butterflies whenever I can. Now I'm going with the washi dots again. And I absolutely love that. Thank you. So one of the biggest tips that I can give you while working on a project is that you don't have to finish it all at once. As you saw here, you saw me flip through a couple of times, adding some things, taking some things off or rearranging things. You don't have to finish a page at that time all at once. If you are uncertain about a part of your project, just leave it and move on to something else. You can always come back to it on a later day, on a later moment, or while you are creating and you find things in your stash. You don't have to finish the whole project, or in this case, the page of a flipbook all at once, because sometimes that's just not happening. And I've just moved on to the fourth page, I believe, in this flipbook, and I found this glass scene bag in my stash, which I wanted to use for some goodies. And I used some of the washi tape that was also part of a Your Creative Studio kit. And now I'm going to add some of these beautiful washi stickers, which I absolutely love. They are one of my favorite things to use also in my personal journal, and I am going to figure out a collage. So here I am with a vellum booklet, but that didn't really give me the look that I wanted. I don't know what it was. Maybe it's because the sticker was too big or the vellum piece was too small. It just didn't give me the look that I wanted, so I teared it up, but it also wasn't what I wanted. And you see a lot of thinking fingers here, which is, yeah, sometimes it just happens. So then I found this piece and I thought it was perfect. So I'm going to add that there, and I'm going to stick my sticker down, and I will add some goodies to that glassine bag. So the paper pad you see here is part of a Your Creative Studio kit, and I'm going to gift some of these to Marlies. I think she will love it. I also checked out her YouTube channel a little bit for her style, and she really loves the Tim Holtz style and the vintage and all those kinds of things. So I thought she would enjoy a couple of these sheets. I thought this was a little bit bare, so I added that green fern leaf. And now this is a different day, because my desk is also cleaned. And I decided to continue this on a different day. So I added some more of the labels that I received in Your Creative Studio kit. And I also took some other labels that I thought I wanted to add as a goodie. Of course, I had to add some of the washi stickers for her, because I love them so much. I use them throughout the flipbook, so I also want to gift that to her. I usually keep in mind what I'm using in the project or in the flipbook, because that's a part of the creative process for me, to match the goodies with what I'm actually making. I have a lot of fun doing that, so I make sure that I will add a little bit of the things that I used, so she could use them herself. Going crazy again with the washi dots, and here I'm going to look through the flipbook to see how I want to continue on the next page. So I found this beautiful butterfly, absolutely love the colors, and I'm going to create a tuck spot with it. So I added this washi sticker as a backing, and then I am going to add a bit of this washi, which is also from AliExpress. I have had this washi for a long time, but I absolutely love the advertising on it. And I'm going to create a little bit more on the background with that. And then I'm thinking on how I want to adhere this, because I want to create a tuck spot for it. So I'm going to stick down the bottom half of the butterfly, and the top half is still open, it's not glued down, so I can stick things under it. I found this little envelope in my stash. I think one of you sent that to me, and I'm going to use that for the labels to gift those to Marlies. And it fit in perfectly and beautifully behind the butterfly. So I am going to continue my collage a little bit. I'm going to add another little sentence, live in the moment, and I'm going to add another sentence, be awesome today. And I think I'm also going to add some washi dots here. Yes, I am. And after that, my page will be finished. So this one came together quite quickly, and that's because I left my project for a couple of days and came back to it with a fresh eye, because that's sometimes all you need. So these papers are also part of the Your Creative Studio kit, and I thought she would like them, as they are more of a vintage style and a vintage theme. So I also always keep in mind the person I am making mail for, or at least I try to. And I took one of the scrap pieces from the papers I cut for this flipbook to add to this book page, and I'm just going to create a pretty collage. I think I made this page during a live stream from Vivian. I think so. She did a Patreon only live stream, so I crafted with her, which was very, very nice, and it also got me distracted a little bit, so I wasn't overthinking it too much. And it was just a lot of fun. So if you want to see more mail related videos, go check out Vivian from the Paper Letter blog. And like I said, Marlies Design, she's also linked down below in the description box, of course. So I would highly recommend you go check out both of them. Because now I know for certain this was during Vivian, her live stream. I always forget that I have wax seals. I absolutely love the look of wax seals, but I forget that I have this. And she was talking about wax seals. I was like, oh, perfect for this project. So I am going to add a wax seal as a decoration here. I don't know if it was a good idea to mix it up with a clothespin, but I did. Because that's what I had on hand. And now I'm going to create a wax seal. And I always like to make it a little bit messy and drip some of the excess as, you know, like kind of enamel dots or something on my project. So that's what I'm doing here. And I have this beautiful wax seal with a butterfly. And I absolutely love how this page turned out. I'm very, very happy with this page. I'm going to add this fern to add a little bit more of the brown. I always keep in mind a bit of the balance in colors. So there was a lot of green, not as much brown. So that is why I added this. And I'm going to finish it off with some washi dots. Moving on to the next page, I found this doily in my stash, which was sent to me by one of you guys, and I'm going to create a 3x4 envelope with my envelope punch board. So this paper size is 6x6, and that makes that I can make a 3x4 envelope, and I am just going to add this envelope to my page to add some more goodies in, because you saw me pick out some papers before, and I'm going to put those in this little envelope. At first I thought I wanted to keep it open, but it was too big. I don't know what I was thinking. So I'm going to close the envelope, but I am using a flower die cut for it. I am very much into, you know, closing things in a different way, so without washi, but just with a beautiful die cut, so you can slip the envelope flap in there. Here you see it. I'm going to use this flower, so I make sure that I will only glue down the bottom part, so you can still open the envelope, but it will stay closed like this. And I'm creating a collage with more leaves, and these stickers are also from AliExpress. this is what I usually like to do, to flip through my project to see what I'm doing so I can continue on it. I found this project life card in my stash, the colors were perfect, and I also found this beautiful flower sticker, which is one of my favorites. So I wanted to use that for this decorative page. I'm also going to use some more of the scraps from the cut off pieces of the pages to create a base for my collage, and because they are from the paper pad and from these pages, they are the perfect size to use again. So I am going to add the project life card on here as a beautiful quote piece. I absolutely love the quote, and I'm going to adhere that flower next to it. This page came together quite quickly, and I'm just going through my stash. This is also a different day, because you can see again my desk is clean. I sometimes need to reorganize my stuff to get a clearer headspace, and that is what I did with this flipbook also, because this is quite elaborate for my snail mail making, because usually I don't do these quite elaborate things. Simply because I have to make sure that I send out 100 grams. Now, Marlies also lives in the Netherlands, so if I had to put an extra stamp on it, it would be okay. Usually I don't make them this elaborate. So here I am going to add some washi samples for her and some of these dots, of course, because I'm obsessed with these dots. So I really wanted to share them with her as well. And these are easy, very simple goodies to share, but they are so much fun. And I hope Marlies will also enjoy using them. So here you saw a little bag. I didn't think it fit the color scheme, and I tuck one of the washi samples in the front, and now I'm going to create a very cool tuck spot. So I'm measuring out how big my spine is, and I'm going to score my butterfly in the middle to line it up with my spine, and I'm going to score two sides of the butterfly to make them flip up. This is not necessary at the end, because I decided to do something else, but you can flip up the pieces. The very important part is to score the middle of the butterfly, so it will not interfere with opening and closing the book. That there's not a bulky piece of cardstock there. So I'm going to stick that down with some glue and making sure it's right up in the middle of the spine. And then I thought, okay, I'm going to put these washi samples in here. I need to stick down the bottom part of these butterflies so they act as tuck spots. So that's what I did. So that is why the second scoring is not necessary, only the scoring in the middle of the spine or in the middle of the butterfly. Of course, I'm also going to decorate this a little bit, and I'm going to use this beautiful doily piece and stick it behind my butterfly to create a little bit more of a background and this beautiful washi sticker. So this last page, I finally had the feeling, yes, I'm going for it, and then I was already done with my project, or already done, it's already a different day, but still. Sometimes you struggle a little bit to get into it, and that's just totally normal. I also have it, so don't feel like you're not creative when you struggle a little bit. I also struggle sometimes. So I'm going to add these washi samples on the other side, and I'm going to create a collage with these two stickers on the right hand side. And I'm going to stick my washi dots and some other images, and I believe some doilies for her to use underneath the other butterfly. So this is quite a big project. I still have to make the envelope with you, and I'm going to make an envelope for this flipbook without using a punch board. So it's just folding and cutting. So if you want to see that, stay tuned, because that will come. I'm going to add another little quote. So if she takes out the goodies, it still looks nice. And here I'm just going to tuck in the goodies, and I'm also going to gift her some of these images I think she would like. I'm not really fond of the words on top of them, but you can fussy cut them out as I did before. Of course, some more washi dots. I blame Hebba for sharing how awesome they are. I'm going to stick my own sticker on the back, and this was the cool part about doing it with eyelets. I created the closure with my flipbook with the middle eyelet. So I thread to this thread through the eyelet twice to create the closure of my flipbook. So here I took one of the big pages I used before to create the flipbook, and I'm going to put my project in there as if I'm going to wrap a little gift. So I'm making sure that I'm folding on the sides, that there is enough space for this flipbook to go in there. And then I will cut on the scoring line, like I'm doing here, and cut a kind of a triangular shape into the other piece. I hope this explains it, because explaining it in words is very difficult. I don't know how to explain it, but I hope seeing this will help you create your own envelopes without an envelope punch board. Now I'm going to cut off a little piece because of the top flap. It doesn't look like an envelope. I'm here making sure if everything will fit nicely. And I'm going to use a template on the other side. So there's this big flap that will make sure that everything will stay inside the envelope. I'm going to use some wet glue for this to make sure that it's really stuck down, because this will go through the postal system. And yay for me, it survived. It arrived at Marlies. Yay! So I'm very happy that it survived. But I always make sure that my mails are very well closed and there are no papers sticking out that can be ripped up. And that's also why I'm going to use this washi tape here to line my envelope. It looks really pretty, but it's also a little bit of an extra protection for your paper to not rip open in the postal system. So I had these labels out and I thought it would be fun to use one of them as an address label. And I went through my stash to find some more of these beautiful vellum stickers to decorate my envelope. And this came together pretty quickly for my doing, you know, with this whole flipbook. So I'm just going to create a collage with these beautiful beautiful washi stickers to match what is inside the envelope. I like to match my envelope with my project, and I think it succeeded. And I also am really happy that I remembered that I could use labels like this as address labels. I usually forget that, but because they were already out, I remembered it. I'm just going to reuse the supplies that I already used before to decorate this envelope. Back of the envelope, I'm going to add another label to write my return address on, and going to decorate that a little bit. And after that, my flipbook will be completed. So if you want to see what Marlies made for me, go check out Marlies Design. She's linked down below in the description box. I also linked down her Instagram. I would love it if you go check her out and tell her you came from me. I'm very excited to open her mail. I will do that after I did this, and I'm very excited to see what she made for me. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video, even though it was a very long one. If you did, I would love it if you give me a thumbs up. I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye!